Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 71 of our Golang course. In this lesson, we will start looking at some of the primitives that the sync package offers to write concurrent programs. So let's get started. We will be covering wait group in this lesson. So let's first start with the need for wait group. We talked about this in the last lesson that there is always at least one go routine, that is for the main function, which is the entry point for any go program. All other go routines that we start using the go keyword run concurrently with the main go routine. This is the model of concurrency that go follows. We start go routines from the main go routine and then expect them to merge back into the main go routine. If we abandon a go routine, it is called a go routine leak. Now, the question is, how do you prevent a go routine leak? One way of doing is with the wait group. So let's look at them. The Go team has created additional concurrency primitives around the traditional concurrency primitives to help you write concurrent programs. The wait group is one such primitive. Wait group is a struct exported from the sync package. Wait group is used to help with go routine completion when your go routine does not compute a result or if you have another way of getting the results back from the go routines. Otherwise, you would use channels and a select statement, which we will see in a later lesson. Here, we have the package docs or the go docs for the wait group. It says, a wait group waits for a collection of go routines to finish. The main go routine calls add to set the number of go routines to wait for. Then each of the go routine runs and calls done when it has finished. At the same time, wait can be used to block until all go routines have finished. So with wait, we can wait for all the go routines to finish. If you remember in one of our examples, we saw that if you start a go routine with a go keyword, there is no guarantee that the go routine will complete before the main program's execution. So with wait group, we can use the wait method to wait for all the go routines to finish. Please note, a wait group must not be copied after the first use. Let's now focus on using wait group. Wait groups are essentially a memory safe counter. By calling the add method, you are incrementing the counter of go routines to wait for, and by calling the done method, you are decrementing the counter. Then the wait method, as the name suggests, is used to wait for all the go routines to finish. Please note that the creation of wait groups, calling the add and wait method should be all done outside of go routines, as there is no guarantee that the go routine will be executed. But we usually call these methods closer to the creation of go routines. The done method, on the other hand, is called inside a go routine to indicate the completion of a go routine. Enough of theory, now let's move on to an example. Here in our package main, I'm going to create a function sayHello. Here, sayHello is a function that accepts a wait group. We will also call sayHello in a go routine. So we will use the wait group passed to us to indicate once the go routine has completed. First thing we do is defer the calling of done method on the passed wait group. This ensures that done is always called when we exit from the go routine. After that, we are just going to print a statement saying hello. Now, in our main function, first let us create a variable of type wait group. We are going to call two go routines. So let's increase the counter of wait group using the add method, and the number of go routines we call is 2. Let us call the sayHello function in a go routine. Go sayHello and then pass the reference to our wait group. Then to wait for both of the go routines to complete, let us call wait on the wait group. At the end, let us print a statement to say both go routines completed. So basically what we did was create a function sayHello which accepts a wait group, and inside it we print a hello statement, and then using defer we call done on wait group. This indicates that the go routine has completed. And inside main, we create a wait group variable. Then we add 2 because we are going to start 2 go routines. After starting those go routines, we wait for the go routine completion. And then we just print a completed statement. Now let us run our program to see how it works. Go run main.go. And as you can see, both the go routines were completed. What happens if I comment out wait? This means we are no longer waiting for the go routines to complete with help of the wait group. Now go run main.go And as you can see, our program did not wait for the completion of the goroutines. So this is one method of ensuring that the goroutines we start are completed and do not leak. Now here we have another example. In this one, we have a function print number which accepts a wait group and then a number to print it to the console. Again, we are calling waitGroup.done with a defer statement to ensure that it's always called. Then we print the number, and then to simulate some work, we are just sleeping for 1 second. Inside the main, again we do the same. We initialize a waitGroup variable, then run a loop to start 3 goroutines. We increment the counter of waitGroup by adding 1 for each goroutine we start. And then we start the goroutine by calling print number with the help of the go keyword, passing the reference to waitGroup and the number. Then we wait again, and once it's all done, we print a message, all numbers have been printed. Now let's run our program again to verify everything works. And as you can see, all numbers were printed. If you notice, they were not printed in sequence. That is because the order of execution of goroutine is not granted. So, as we have seen in this lesson, waitGroup is a very helpful way in making sure that all our goroutines are completed and they don't leak. But they shouldn't be used when your goroutine produces a result that your program depends on. Essentially, waitGroups are a simple way of making sure that goroutines are completed. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!